perfect timing because the conversation from what we prayed about led into fasting as well. So check that out, boys. So there's a couple of ladies at work that I've been sharing God with, and one of them is a complete Buddhist, and I've just been sharing her with God's love, and then she's become really sick and she's had a lot of messed up things in her life, so I've just kept pouring God's love into that. And then there's this other lady who has a daughter who is an adult, has three kids, and she opened up to me a couple of weeks ago about her daughter, and she said from an early age, from her primary school years, the teacher said there's something wrong with your daughter. And the mum just thought, you know, she's just a kid, a little bit different. But as she got older, she really suffered from, I guess, what we call OCD. And she's, like now she's an adult, and it's so bad. It affects the whole family, it affects her husband. And if the mum and her other older daughters are eating cake, the other daughter won't touch the cake. She won't touch anything that other people have touched. It's just full on, and you know, it's so close to destroying her relationship with her husband. And you know, her mom, she was just in tears telling me, and she knows that I'm a Christian, and I said, you know, Louise, I'm really going to pray for your daughter. And so this was happening as well, and so the two names we I brought up at a prayer group, and the one person that I thought, yes, I'm going to break free of this Buddhism and she's going to know God's love and it's going to fill her heart and she'll feel at peace. She pretty much, because I sent a text saying, hey, you know, we can come and pray over you, and, you know, because I gave her a book on miracles, and she said, this is the best book I've ever written. So I thought, yeah, that's a big sign. So now I'll send this text, we'll pray over you, and, you know, God's going to shower you with his love. And the next day, I just get this blank no. And, you know, I just cried because I thought, man, I just want you to experience God's love. And I was heartbroken because I thought she's searching everywhere for love, but the one person or the one being that can give it to her, she's just at this stage not interested. But then, so I get to work. I have to go to the other pharmacy, which I never normally do. So I've literally hopped out of the car. 2 minutes later, I'm at the other pharmacy. The lady walks in, who doesn't normally come at that time, and this is all before 8 o'clock, and she bumps into me and she goes, Tish, I've just got a text from my daughter. She's texted me and she said that she's just woken up. It's the day after we pray from prayer group. She's woken up and she feels just such joy and such happiness and such peace.
Wow, thank you.
And I said, Louise, last night we had a prayer group and we all prayed for your daughter, all of us. And I said, thank God. She said, yes, thank God. And we're all so happy. And this was, and then later on that day, she came down to our pharmacy. And I was saying, Louise, you know, because she said the other thing about the fasting was that the mum, Louise, was saying to me, you know, I've been trying to lose weight and I've tried every diet under the sun. And I've finally come up with something, you know, because she grew up in a Catholic family. I've realised that gluttony is a sin, so, you know, I'm just going to focus on that and it's working. I said, well, Louise, you know, we went to New Zealand, we got this book and it's on fasting. And I haven't just been praying for your daughter, I've been fasting for your daughter as well. And she goes, oh, have you? I said, yeah. And like, you know, in the Bible, Louise, it says that, you know, Jesus said these things require much prayer and fasting, and so that's what I've been doing for your daughter. And, you know, she was so touched, and I said, I'm going to bring you the book, and you can fast. And she was so excited. So the next day, I gave her the book, and I gave her a little note, and so I get to see you next week. But that's the power of prayer and fasting. That's the power of Jesus.